I'm Christina Fuges, editorial director with MoldMaking Technology, and I'm here with Steve Kline Jr., chief data officer with Gardner Business Intelligence, to share some good news. First, Amerimold is right around the corner. The first live event for the mold manufacturing marketplace in over a year. September 21st to the 23rd in Rosemont, Illinois. And from what I can tell, this community is ready to engage, to network, to learn, and investigate and invest in new technology and processes, which ties nicely to Steve's good news about the Gardner Business Index for mold making. So Steve, why don't you give us a breakdown of the numbers?
Yeah, so Christina, in May, we saw the Mold Making Business Index hit its highest level ever, a reading of 62.3, which is quite strong on this type of index. And basically every subcomponent of the index was growing in May. Now, of course, supply chain disruption is a big topic in manufacturing, and supplier deliveries are lengthening quite a bit in the mold making industry. The good news is that in May, the amount of lengthening was slightly less than what it was in April. So maybe we're starting to get a reprieve a little bit from the supply chain disruption. But the really positive news is that new orders, production, and the backlog index are all at or near record levels in the mold making industry. And in particular, I pay the most attention to backlogs. You want to see mold shops having a healthy backlog of molds that they need to build that helps sustain the industry going forward. So it's a good sign that we're seeing backlogs right now. And then one other subcomponent to mention is the export index. In two of the last 3 months, exports were growing compared to the previous month. And we haven't seen that happen in roughly 3 years or so in the mold making industry. So there's a lot of demand both domestically and internationally for mold making.
So how does this relate to the various end markets that mold manufacturers serve?
So we can look at the business index by a variety of mold market end markets. We have about 20 or so end markets that we track. If we look at that on a month-by-month basis, over the last 3 months, virtually every single end market that we track has been growing month over month. It's the first time that's ever happened in the history of our business index, which we started in December of 2011. So whether it's the automotive industry or custom processors or just injection molders, the electronics, the medical industry, every one of these industries is growing. So the recovery in manufacturing has been very widespread and very strong in every one of these industries.
So other data is about purchasing products and equipment. So let's talk about the planned spending by mold building facilities.
So one of the things that we have in the business index, and we don't talk about it a whole lot, but we ask manufacturing facilities, what do you plan to spend on capital equipment in the next 12 months? So we're not asking them what they've already done, but what they plan to do. And in the mold making industry for mold manufacturers, they're planning to spend about $600,000 per facility in the next 12 months. This is the highest that we've seen basically in the last 2 years. So obviously that hit a low point last April during the initial part of the economic lockdowns during the beginning of the pandemic, and then it has steadily grown since then. So demand for new capital equipment and new technology amongst mold making facilities is basically at the highest we've seen it in the last 2 years.
I told you this was good news. And I don't know about you, but it gets me more excited about bringing this whole mold manufacturing marketplace together at Amerimold. It's really going to help continue to keep mold making moving forward. We hope to see you in Chicago this September 21st to the 23rd, and check out AmerimoldExpo.com for event details on Amerimold, the molding conference, and extrusion. And remember, meet me in Chicago.